In this demonstration, we'll walk through an example use case of Jama for developing products that require functional safety verification. This Tier 1 automotive supplier designs and engineers airbags, sensors, and other vehicle safety components. It's the third variant in the company's supplemental restraint airbag system product line, and like most products in this category, combines multiple engineering disciplines, including mechanical and electrical. Jama is a centralized repository, the hub of development efforts across multiple teams, and here consolidates the multiple facets of the airbag system. As of today, the stakeholder requirements and the system requirements have been defined. Those are being broken down into subsystem requirements. The team is also identifying hazard and safety goals, all within Jama and without the need for additional spreadsheet. The supplemental restraint airbag system product line has multiple variants that support the specific needs of various OEMs. We reuse the requirements, validations, and verifications. By starting with the data that has already met strict compliance standards, the company increases confidence that the new variant will meet functional safety goals. Jama's reuse functionality makes it easy to see the differences between individual requirements. If we want to sync changes back to the original item, we have that option. Alternately, we can look across the product as a whole. Changes can then once again be manually synced between the original and the new project as needed. Jama's collaboration functionality shows what's important when. I can look at the conversation happening around an individual item and answer when I'm called in to close a call to action or make a decision. I can see an open issue from Becky, one of our market researchers. I can quickly jump into the conversation, make an edit, and notify that the change has been made. If they have a question about why something was changed, the version information directs them to the right person to talk to and shows them that change. What appears to be a quick change can have impacts downstream. Now that we've made the change requested by our subject matter expert, we need to understand the rippling impacts across the rest of the product line. Per ASPICE guidelines and the company's international process, the following relationship rules need to be fulfilled. Because we are looking at a system requirement, we know that it can have multiple other downstream and upstream items tied to it, including subsystem requirements, system verifications, validation cases and risks. Any one of these might need to be updated based on the changes we've made to our system requirement. Because of that change, Jama flags the existing downstream items that need to be, at a minimum, assessed for potential change as suspect. As the analysis is completed, the subject flags can be cleared. We also want to ensure we have coverage across the project. Because we're producing a regulated product, system requirements, as an example, require downstream validations. Without that, it's impossible to show compliance with regulations. Jama's Coverage Explorer allows us to easily see how information is tied together across our product. Identify and determine gaps quickly where more traceability is required for a compliance requirement. Status from other tools, Jira as an example, flow back so developers can work in their tool of choice but keep you updated. Coverage Explorer helps you understand the full scope of the project so you can effectively communicate expectations to key stakeholders. One of the problem areas with requirements and specifications is getting closure around approvals. Jama has powerful capabilities for reviews in the form of Review Center. As the moderator, I'll first set a review deadline. Setting this time box communicates the expectations around feedback and will help me when I'm trying to whittle that 4-hour requirements meeting I usually have down to an hour. I designate people to be a part of the review, whether they're approvers, meaning I'll get their signature, or reviewers, who I think of as my subject matter experts. Once feedback starts to pour in from various stakeholders, it's easy to see where different requirements have been approved or disapproved and the comments of proposed changes on which I need to act. Instead of jumping between documents and red lines, all stakeholders and feedback are in one place, easy to access and act upon. With the Jama Review Center, you can remove the overhead of requirements reviews and shorten the time between milestones.